This is the game the local folks have been looking forward to, LSU at home. Purdue, though, have not been looking forward to this one, playing a tournament game on the road here in Baton Rouge. The NCAA has assigned Nick Papereau, James Birch, and Paul Green to the ball game here tonight. And it should be a wild one with the Fighting Tigers of LSU home to take on the Boilermakers of Purdue. A couple of great coaches and good ball clubs.
I think one of the keys for Purdue, Bob, they need to get on top of the LSU Tigers early as possible to get this crowd out of the game.
Interesting, when they introduced the lineups, Ricky Blanton almost looked embarrassed to go out there as the center at 6'6 against the 6'9, 235 of Melvin McCants. There's a lot of great matchups out there tonight. John Williams and Todd Mitchell. And then, of course, the guards, Troy Lewis and Derek Taylor. At midcourt, it'll be Mitchell against Blanton as they will actually jump it up, Purdue will, with the forward. Nothing unusual for them. Here we go with the Boilermakers in their home whites, LSU in their traveling purple, but they're right here at home. And Matt Gattis has it for the Boilermakers, and the Tigers open up in a man-to-man defense. Dale Brown said yesterday that the condition of John Williams' legs would probably determine what defense they play, Joe, and now that he's okay, they're playing the man-to-man, and there's a steal, Derek Taylor.
LSU will change defenses. They've opened up in the man defense. We'll watch it and see how it goes. Purdue the same. They're man-to-man pressure.
Eric Taylor on the drive.
They cleared the right side, and he simply whipped Gattis one-on-one.
Taylor, a six-foot senior from Baton Rouge, an All-American at Redemptorist High School here locally. Here's Todd Mitchell for Purdue. Doug Lee from Matt Gattis. The only senior starter, Troy Lewis from long range, 6'4 sophomore, Anderson, Indiana, a former co-mister basketball in the great basketball state, and he averages 18 a game. Gattis almost had the steal. This is John Williams, the great sophomore of the Tigers. Todd Mitchell got a piece of it on the way up, as did Matt Gattis, and Gattis will be called for the foul.
The last offensive set by Purdue, they ran a screen down, and what I liked about Troy Lewis, he just came off shooting. He has plays with a lot of confidence. He got nothing but the bottom of the sack.
Don Redden will inbound the basketball. Gene Cady upset with the officials. He was asked yesterday at his press conference if he'd like to warm the press up with an opening statement. He said, I don't have to. I've been hot since Sunday when I saw the pairings come out.
And you can't really blame him.
Here's Matt Gattis. Time to forget about that, though, and time to play ball. Doug Lee, the former Aggie of Texas A&M, missing long. But Melvin McCants and Lewis get it back on top for Matt Gattis. Herb Robinson on the bench, the only other senior on this team. They've been called Katie's kids, baby boilers. They love them up in West Lafayette. Here's Mitchell into the paint, and he was fouled. John Williams.
He's matched up against Todd Mitchell. And the other matchup is Anthony Wilson against Troy Lewis. Of course, Troy Lewis, the leading scorer on the Purdue Boilermaker team. And there's Gene Cady directing traffic for his team.
Six straight postseason tournaments for him. Dale Brown, four 20-win seasons out of the eight in LSU history. And at the line is Todd Mitchell, a 6'7 sophomore from Toledo. 80% from the line. He's the number one rebounder on this team. And this year was number three in the Big Ten from the stripe. A second team All-Big Ten performer as chosen by UPI. He only scored in double figures 28 times this year.
And he leads this team on the boards at 7-2 a game.
Rebound, Ricky Blanton on the miss. Purdue 3, LSU 2, we're a minute 45 in.
McCants is matched up against John Williams. Could be an interesting matchup because Williams will go outside.
Doug Lee got a touch on Don Redden, who is flashing across the lane. The officials are obviously going to keep a close eye on this one. These two teams, and I think more so the Boilermakers, have reputations as physical ball clubs.
They both come to play, and they'll both really get after you defensively. Both opened up in that man defense, as we said, and it's tenacious.
Second team foul on the Boilers. This is Redden on the left side, is playing with a bruised thigh, but he told me before the game he felt just fine. And on the turnover, it'll belong to the Boilermakers.
He stepped on the in line as he made his cut.
Melvin McCants, a freshman. Out of Mount Carmel High School, Chicago, this is Doug Lee for Troy Lewis. Matt Gaddis doesn't shoot often. A little short with that one. John Williams tips it out. Here come the Tigers. Derek Taylor.
Yes. That's what he does. He won't take it all the way to the basket. He'll pull up short on the break, hoping that he's got exposure on the glass.
The number six all-time LSU scorer, now 1,513 points. In his great career, Doug Lee is 0 for 2. Wilson. Anthony comes up with it. Here's Taylor, the go-go man of the LSU offense. 4-3, Tigers early. 3 minutes in. Williams, baseline right against McCants. Uses the pivot nicely.
That's a tough matchup, as I mentioned. McCants, 6'9", 235. He's got his work cut out for him to handle John Williams, who's super quick.
John Williams, intestinal virus earlier this year that had him feeling very badly 48 hours ago. Felt better yesterday, and actually them playing the late game here tonight helped him even more. He's almost 100% for this one. Troy Lewis.
Good pick, and boy, he can drive. Leads him in scoring, 18-6 a game.
53% from the field. He's also Mr. Clutch, Joe.
I don't know if Anthony Wilson has enough quickness and is a good enough defensive performer to handle him. Sort of the same as the McCants-Williams matchup.
6-5, home team on top. Williams, ever so smooth. He never looks like he breaks a sweat out there. He's got it all.
There are some who think he is the best sophomore in America.
And wait till you see him lead the fast break. Todd Mitchell missing with the left-handed shot. And a foul on Melvin McCants on the offensive board. Foul number three against Purdue.
Let's look at big John Williams again. You see him here with the ball pivoting. Watch him. This big, quick step here, right here, and he gets inside. Melvin McCants goes to the glass and brings it home. Gene Cady thought maybe he took steps. It was close.
An NBA scout has referred to John Williams as a 6'8 Elgin Baylor. Quite a compliment. Derek Taylor cannot hit. Todd Mitchell clears the board, as he often does for Gene Cady's team. Good hustle by Don Redden, who skips over the press table on an attempted steal. Now he'll have to go around like the rest of us do when we take the floor.
Mitchell boards well, as we mentioned, leads this team, but he blocks out so well. And of course, that's the secret.
Dale Brown said yesterday that Don Redden hasn't been able to do the things he's capable of doing because of the thigh. Hasn't practiced much, but with that spirit on that last play, you would think that he's feeling okay. Todd Mitchell, his first field goal. Todd has three. He averages 16, and he leads the team at 55% from the field, along with his teammate, Melvin McCants.
Purdue's been running their offense, though, very well. They've had good spacing on their offense. They've had good picks on their motion, and they're getting the good wide-open shot for Mitchell and Lewis, and they're hitting.
Gene Cady is known as one of the coaches that really gets a lot out of his team. Year after year, they do better than they were forecast to in preseason. This one belongs to LSU, and we have an official's timeout on the court with the score, LSU 8 and Purdue 7.
I am not a plumber.
I am not a carpenter.
I am not an electrician.
We know you're not. Next time, come see us first. Ace, the helpful place.
Raise your hand, you got it. Raise your hand.
Sure Unscented. It's the number one selling unscented antiperspirant. Get outstanding odor and wetness protection, minus the heavy scent.
Raise your hand, raise your hand.
Old pals.
Don't shoot, it's us!
I know!
New problems.
Cynthia's been kidnapped.
And a rude awakening. Bruce Willis, Matthew Perry.
Thank God the killers are here.
The whole 10 yards, rated PG-13. Starts Friday, April 9th.
Handle to Gervin down low. Gervin takes the shot. Good! 33.
Go Moses, shoot it, Moses.
Thing I could do is finger
Vance Carter, a rolling dirty.
It all comes down to this.
this. Holy Toledo.
Bob Carpenter along with Joe Dean at the Assembly Center in Baton Rouge, where we played.
Go, go,
5 minutes and 7 seconds. Purdue hanging tough. LSU has the one-point lead at 8-7. It's the first meeting ever between the two schools. And you might say the Purdue folks in black and gold are a bit outnumbered here tonight, although they did bring a couple of hundred that are sitting behind us, along with Pat Cady, the wife of head coach Gene. Tough for her to sit in a crowd like this. And here's Derek Taylor for LSU.
Purdue just 3 of 7 shooting so far.
John Redden faked the shot, dumped it down to Anthony Wilson. On the steal, Troy Lewis had the ball hit the baseline on him.
LSU is 4 of 6 so far from the field.
Taylor for Redden. How's he shooting? I think that answers the question.
Williams picked down for him, and he was wide open.
He's averaging 12 a game and shooting 51% from the field. Don Redden carried this team for a week earlier in the year.
LSU's made the first defensive change. They've gone a 2-3 zone.
Doug Lee.
He wasted no time picking it up, I'll tell you that.
Doug averages 9 a game, shooting 51%. He started the last 29 games of the regular season. Here's Redden driving against Lee. Can't get it. Todd Mitchell fouled. It appears to be Anthony Wilson.
Over the back. Anthony Wilson, his first.
Second team foul on LSU. They've led by one consistently here in this tight ball game. So, Joe, I think really if we look back on the first 6 minutes or so, this one would be pretty much as we expected.
No question. Everybody thought it would be close. Oh, beautiful pass by Gattis.
Matt Gattis for Todd Mitchell, who has 5.
LSU in that zone defense. They went to sleep on the weak side. Great cut and a beautiful pass.
Here's Taylor. Getting by Gattis with help from a pick. Skying for the board, and there's the presence of the big freshman, Melvin McCants, followed by a very unnecessary foul by Derek Taylor.
Shot selection by Derek Taylor, not good. And then he goes back and fouls, and big Melvin McCants up on the glass. He needs to board for this team.
Derek tried to make up for one bad play with another, didn't he?
And it cost him. LSU back man-to-man. They've made another defensive change.
Troy Lewis. Little short, Doug Lee with the tip, and it won't go for him. Anthony Wilson for Derek Taylor. Here come the running Tigers. John Williams. Anthony Wilson over Troy Lewis.
Well, that's his game. He's a spot shooter. He can be very streaky. When he's hot, he's hot. And when he's not, he's not. But he played string music there.
LSU 17-1 this year when Anthony shoots 50% or better from the field.
And Lee says, I can respond with you, Anthony Wilson.
Doug Lee is
like
a tough ball player.
And he's a tough, hard-nosed guy.
If you look at the right-hand side of your screen up there, you see his right knee with a black bandage on it. There's a reason for that. It's not for show. He's been banged around on the floor a lot this year. And the foul, or rather the turnover, traveling by Don Redden. Matt Gattis will take a seat for Purdue. And into the ballgame is number 21, an exciting young guard, the point guard of the future with it right now, Everett Stevens. You've got to see this guy jump. He hasn't started a game all year, and he leads the team in blocks. Short with the jumper. Melvin McCants once and twice.
Good offensive board work for the big guy. Doug Lee, though, he forced a turnover the last time against LSU because he put the good defensive pressure on Redden.
Boilermakers by 3, and the fans are a little quiet here locally. Gene Cady said a big key would be how his team played early to keep the Tiger fans in their seats. Williams for Redden. John Williams. There's Redden picking up the loose ball. Doug Lee fell down. That gave Redden the path to the hoop.
He fell down and the ball bounced just perfect for Redden. And of course, nobody really blocked him out on that side.
Gene Cady up, barking some more defensive, now offensive signals. Here's Everett Stevens for Troy Lewis. Doug Lee. Nothing shy about this guy when it comes to shooting. Doug Lee has 6, and he's hit 3 in a row. And, Joe, he missed his first 2, but you like to see a guy who's got the confidence to keep on coming.
He believes it, stayed with it, and there was a tough move for him. But he whipped Redden one-on-one, just got under him. Tough basket, made it go.
Boilermakers by 3. We're almost 9 minutes in. Here's Anthony Wilson, kicks it outside for Redden with the shot fake and traveling again.
Defensive pressure by Doug Lee. Twice he's forced the turnover.
Herb Robinson into the ball game. Dale Brown shuttles in his man. It appears to be number 30, Bernard Woodside, a 6'6 sophomore out of Hempstead, New York. And Purdue has brought in their man.
LSU has four turnovers, Purdue just two so far.
Herb Robinson for the Boilermakers, number 32, the only senior on the team besides Matt Gattis. Todd Mitchell to the baseline, out of bounds, off him. Good D by John Williams and company.
He simply shut him off at the baseline, and I think Mitchell thought maybe he got a piece of it, but he didn't.
Williams for Derek Taylor. Rich Stevens watching it. Anthony Wilson on the left side for Bernard Woodside. And Mr. Williams is drawing some company on the baseline, isn't it? There's the rebound for Melvin McCants.
When he gets it, he's drawing a crowd. They're really packing it in.
That makes the shooting of the guards important. That time, Purdue never got in their offense. And Gene Cady is really up off the bench, giving it to his guard, Everett Stevens, for giving up that ball and the 2 points. Ricky Blanton with his first basket.
Well, Gene Cady made the statement, if they hit real well outside, it'll create a lot of problems for us because I know they'll go to John Williams on the inside. He has to gamble a little bit to try to shut down John Williams, who's so physical and so strong.
Everett Stevens to Todd Mitchell, who had beaten John Williams. And then Williams had to foul him to stop the two. And that's number two on the 6'8 sophomore out of L.A.
Pass was perfect, though, away from the defensive player. Williams was trying to front. They threw it on the opposite side away from the defensive player. And there was Mitchell ready to bring it home. He'll shoot two.
You saw Jose Vargas a moment ago, a 6'9 sophomore for LSU. At the line, Todd Mitchell.
Purdue finished fourth in the Big Ten. LSU finished fifth in the Southeastern Conference. You see the numbers on Mitchell.
Todd Mitchell.
Impressive.
Todd Mitchell says Gene Cady reminds him of Sidney Moncrief. Gene used to be an assistant at Arkansas.
That's
and Sidney
lot,
Moncrief.
Bob.
Yeah, because he's a player that does it all, offense and defense. And there's Todd doing it all, but not in the right way this time, reaching over the top of Jose Vargas.
Anytime you come over the back, it's almost an automatic call.
Mitchell will have a seat. We'll have a timeout. We've got 9:57 remaining in the first half of play. A timeout on the court with the score for Purdue 18, LSU 16.
You've got to step up. Close out all of the pressure. Trust everything you've been taught. And just believe you can do it. You know, my first day on the job sure felt familiar.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Announcing an amazing achievement in sports. The end of messy athlete's foot cream with maximum strength Gold Bond foot swabs. Snap to release the only medicine proven to cure and prevent most athlete's foot. Gold Bond foot swabs, the no mess, no touch cure.
Now, when people come to H&R Block for the first time, I give them a second chance. I double check their past returns for free to see if I can find them any more money. And when we find something, it averages about $1,500.
Double check, another advantage of H&R Block.
John Wooden. He's really General Patton underneath it all. Rick Pitino.
He doesn't think small time. He thinks very, very big.
Two legendary coaches. Two Sports Century World Premieres tonight, back to back. From the old school.
He could make a player cry.
And he never swore. To the new school.
You don't say no to Rick Pitino.
Sports Century John Wooden premieres at 8 p.m. tonight. Followed by the premiere of Sports Century Rick Pitino at 8:30. Only on ESPN Classic.
America's favorite home gym is more affordable than ever. Now you can get the all-new Bowflex Extreme for just $19 a month. Call the number on your screen for a free DVD or video and check it out. Bowflex's power rod technology delivers results. Powerful arms, defined legs, a stronger chest, and a toned, sexy core. And owning a Bowflex home gym is so affordable. Great results are easy with a new Extreme. All it takes is one simple workout, 20 minutes a day, three times a week, to get in the best shape of your life. The Extreme is built so well that we back it with an unrivaled 7-year warranty. And so effective, it comes with Bowflex's 100% satisfaction guarantee. Through this special offer, you can own one with no money down and just $19 per month. You can't get this Bowflex deal anywhere else. Call us for a free DVD or video, or visit us online and find out how to get your Bowflex for just $19 a month today.
Well, the Boilermaker mascot may be pretty happy right now. His team down by 4. But, Joe, what's the report on Melvin McCants?
Purdue trainer tells me they've taken him to the hospital here in Baton Rouge for x-rays. He will not play, obviously, tonight. And they're concerned that he will be out for the remainder of the season. And, of course, if they could win here tonight, still be a tremendous blow for them because they've lost their physicalness on the inside.
Yeah, great draw for Purdue. If you beat LSU on their home floor, you get to play Memphis State. That one short by Troy Lewis as we come back. Troy with the follow, and now it's a 2-point game as Lewis, the man we talked about who only had 4 at the half, now has a half dozen.
Gannis is trying to pick Derek Taylor up all over the court.
Jeff Arnold is the man under pressure now. Bar Purdue, number 43, with the big center out of there. Don Redden with the jumper for the left side. Fouled by Doug Lee, and that's number 3 on Lee.
I think he got him after the shot. I don't believe he was in the act of shooting. But that's 3 on Doug Lee, and that is a critical call against Purdue. Gene Cady, tough decision for him now because Lee's really been playing well.
Anthony Wilson. This is John Williams. We've seen flashes of his brilliance in this game. Ricky Blanton on top to Redden. Here's Williams over Arnold, too hard with it. And Matt Gattis. Boilers a chance to get back even with Doug Lee ripping from outside, and he has a dozen.
Lewis hits, Lee hits, game tied. Purdue coming out of the dressing room ready to play. They're man-to-man defensively. Arnold matched up against Williams on the inside.
Minute 20 in. First 4 points of this half belong to the Boilermakers. Here's Redden over Lee. Short with it. Here comes Troy Lewis and Matt Gattis 2-on-2 against Derek Taylor and Don Redden. And a great move by Troy Lewis gives him 8.
6 unanswered points. They had the numbers 2-against-1. Beautiful move by Lewis.
John Williams. Ooh, nice pass for Blanton.
Big guy can pass so well. He sees the court. At one point during the middle of the season, Big John Williams led LSU in assists, if you can believe it, at 6'8", 240.
41 each. 2 minutes into the second half. Matt Gattis for Troy Lewis. A little short with it. Ricky Blanton, who Gene Cady recruited out of Miami but couldn't get to visit West Lafayette, with the rebound. Outside, Derek Taylor. He's into double figures.
Gattis has got to put pressure on the point of the ball. He let him push him down with the ball. Didn't put the pressure on, and he drilled it from about 18.
Doug Lee for Jeff Arnold.
LSU man-to-man defensively.
Nice ball down deep.
Purdue's running their offense very well against the LSU man defense. Good motion, they're getting good picks, and they're getting excellent shots.
Rod Mitchell leading all scorers with 17 after that basket. Into the paint, look at the move of Derek Taylor.
No weak side help defensively by Purdue. And that's unusual for them.
Derek starting his 51st straight ball game tonight. Jeff Arnold against Ricky Blanton. Bob Mitchell for Troy Lewis. Matt Gattis from outside. Don Redden down the court. Here's Williams. Right around Troy Lewis. Missing once and twice. And then fouling. Or was he fouled?
They're saying he was fouled underneath. Against Mitchell.
Number 2 on Todd.
Let's look at it again. Looked like LSU had the numbers, but you can see Mitchell, he got back very quickly defensively. Williams trying to go one-on-one there. Misses it, gets his own rebound. And I think they felt that he was fouled right there before the next tip. But they evidently said he fouled while he was still on the floor. You can throw it over on that situation. It's not an over and back, and I'm sure some fans wondered there. But they said he was still not shooting. Of course, a tip is not a shot.
John Williams taking on Jeff Arnold. Everett Stevens comes in to help out. Here he comes down the paint. With the soft touch, Todd Mitchell has the rebound. Oliver Brown took a shot on that play. Excellent. Mitchell has 19.
Good board work by Mitchell. He just stayed with it. They missed the shot. He followed it up, and bodies were all over the court. Let's look at it again. Right here, great steal by Stevens. He misses the shot. But here comes Mitchell. He leads this team in rebounding, and you can see why.
45 each.
We got a good one.
Yeah, and you've got to like the way this Purdue team came out of the locker room. They had every reason to hang their heads, losing Melvin McCants. They came out storming. Williams short. He's got some people in his face, and he has not shot well here in the second half. Eric Taylor has, though. He dishes for Redden, who's had a good night. Williams against Jeff Arnold. And Jeff called for the foul. It'll be his first. Since his freshman year, Jeff Arnold has added 15 pounds to his frame. He goes 6'10", up from 210 to 225. This is a young team. There's the hurt player, Oliver Brown. Took some kind of shot in the eye on that play a moment ago. Don Redden has 15. We talked about the youth of this Purdue team. A lot of folks feel that the Boilermakers and Iowa will be two very good teams in the Big Ten this year because they have young players who have experience.
Purdue only starts one senior, and they only have two on the roster.
Everett Stevens long with it. If Everett Stevens has one area to work on a little bit, it might be his outside shooting. And how about that play by Doug Lee? He got the touch, then Redden knocked it out of bounds. Doug Lee will never be outworked by anybody.
Mitchell is 7 of 8 from the field. Dale Brown of LSU didn't like the call.
No, that is not a freeze frame, folks. That is a live shot. He was very stoic.
Well, that's been a great matchup all night long, Redden and Lee.
Todd Mitchell loose on the baseline. He got in behind John Williams.
Oh, he's doing it. Only missed one shot all night long.
Todd's high, 27 at Michigan State earlier this year. He has 21 already tonight. There's another turnover. Everett Stevens, and Redden took it away from him. Oh, that's a four-point swing right there, Jodine. Instead of a Purdue fast break, an easy two for LSU. Doug Lee trying to answer. Todd Mitchell does. John Williams, foul number three.
And again, Mitchell, offensive board, and just brought it back to the glass.
He's controlling the ball game right now.
No question about it.
John Williams will leave with those three fouls. Back in. Oliver Brown to replace him.
Williams may be a little bit weak because he had kind of a 24-hour virus that they announced in the paper here during just as the press conferences and the teams were practicing, but he started play well early, but looks a little tired, and he's shooting short.
It's always a sign, isn't it?
No question. Mitchell, they mentioned, has only missed one shot, 8 for 9. He has 21 points, 4 boards, 5 of 7 at the line. What a night he's having. He's just kind of, as you said, Bob, taking over the game.
Just a sophomore.
He was second team, all Big Ten. They say he's the most improved guy on this team. He's tough. Averaging 15.6 a game, but he's having a big game here tonight.
That was after a freshman year when he averaged 7 a game and started only 5. Timeout on the court with the score. Purdue and LSU tied at 49. We'll be back after this timeout.
Now, what self-respecting doctor would drive this thing?
Dr. Drake.
The Johnsons are on their big family trip.
There's driving right there.
And it's gonna be one wild ride. on April 7th.
Ow. Back off, my daughter. I dance with wolves.
Get on board. Never pick up strangers.
Tell me you're not about to pick up a hitchhiker.
Baby, what would Jesus do?
Johnson Family Vacation, rated PG-13. Starts Wednesday, April 7th.
Hey, what is it?
I realize I love you, but as long as you're with Jessica, there can never be anything between
Listen,
us.
Cassie, there's no need to cry. Besides, I've got really great news.
You're leaving Jessica?
No. I just saved a load of money on my car insurance by switching to Geico. I saved. I thought that meant something to you.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Whoa. Digital widescreen high-definition TVs with digital auto convergence and HD component video inputs, plus high-speed velocity scan modulation. Don't touch.
Hey, guys, check out the game in high-def.
Sweet.
Now pay no interest for 2 years or get 10% off all TVs $399 and up. Thousands of possibilities. Get yours. Best Buy.
One swing. Changed everything.
And it's Henry Aaron.
Remembering 7:15, all day April 8th, starting at 11:30 on ESPN Classic.
Baseball's back. Now relive the greatest games from the 2003 playoffs, plus the story behind the curse of the Babe and the Billy Goat. All day Sunday. Then at 7 p.m., the ESPN original documentary, only on ESPN Classic.
You're going to see the steal coming up here by Everett Stevens of Purdue. Right here, he made the steal, but Don Redden of LSU, right there, number 44. Quick hands, he steals it back, brings it all the way back for the easy basket. That gave LSU a 49-47 lead, but Mitchell came right back to get two free throws, and with 14:32 to go, this game is tied again at 49-all, and head coach Gene Katie of Purdue directing traffic. Full court pressure by Purdue now.
Don Redden got it in for Derek Taylor.
See the shooting percentages in the first half? And in the second half, LSU's really cooled off.
Don Redden partially blocked on that play. And here's Everett Stevens for Purdue. Into the paint, missing with the shot, but the tip by Doug Lee.
Beautiful offensive board. They have all of a sudden taken over the offensive glass. LSU did it in the first half. It's Purdue's turn. Mitchell and Lee. Nobody blocked him off. Redden was slow getting back down court after having that shot blocked.
Redden against Todd Mitchell with a left-handed hook.
Horrible shot.
Or whatever it was, a push, hook, whatever.
Shot selection just brutal.
Troy Lewis off the foot there of Anthony Wilson. Watch Doug Lee at the offensive end.
Last two sets right here. Questionable shot right here by Everett Stevens. I didn't like what he put up. Under too much pressure, he didn't get it. But a beautiful tip in right there by Doug Lee. Did he get up? But LSU returned to favor. Pure shot selection by Don Redden. Williams is back in for LSU.
Everett Stevens. Just can't get any to fall, can he?
Maybe a kind of a step out of his range, though, Bob. That was out there pretty far.
There's a takeaway. Jeff Arnold behind Williams forcing the turnover. Everett Stevens cut off. And a foul on Derek Taylor, his third.
Taylor went for the steal, didn't get it. Third foul. That's the second team foul on LSU this half. Purdue's committed three.
Boilers by two, 13:29 remaining. Dale Brown's team led by four at the half, but a six-zip Purdue run in the first minute and a half of this second half made the difference. And the Boilers are starting to get some offensive rebounds.
LSU's gone away from the man. They've gone to his own.
Todd Mitchell fighting off Ollie Brown. Troy Lewis baseline left, and Brown stripped it away from him with an alert play, but it still belongs to Purdue.
Troy Lewis and Todd Mitchell playing a little ping pong over there on that far side, trying to get something to open up.
Doug Lee for Everett Stevens. Winner of this game plays Memphis State, who easily handled Ball State of the Mid-American Conference earlier this evening. Troy Lewis wants to shoot them into the next round. He has 10, six of them since halftime. He and Todd Mitchell have done it.
They really have, and Purdue's matched their biggest lead, and LSU wants to talk about it.
LSU calls a timeout with 12:47 remaining. It's Purdue 53, LSU 49. The home team looking for the answers.
What am I? Am I a basketball player who's a psychology major? Or am I a psychology major who's a basketball player? You know, that's the thing about psychology. You tend to overanalyze everything.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
We're witnessing a college basketball miracle. Dick Vitale silent for an entire 17 seconds. On a personal note, for myself and sportscasters everywhere, I'd like to thank the crust, the juicy toppings, and the pizza delivery guy.
For fresh baked pizza at home. Pick up DiGiorno for the game and you could win NCAA Final Four tickets for life. Look for details on specially marked packages or visit kraftfoods.com.
I'm Roy Hobbs, your new right fielder.
His story, mysterious. His feats, legendary. His passion, undying.
When I walk down the street, people say, there goes Roy Hobbs, the best there ever was.
Sunday, Robert Redford.
Pick me out a winner, Bobby.
The Natural. Plus, find out how real sports legends feel about this Hollywood classic.
That dream exists in every little boy's head.
Real Classics with Burt Reynolds, 8 Eastern Sunday on ESPN Classic.
You got a problem? Now you do. It's Hooligans and Thugs, soccer's most violent fan fights. Playing this month on Dish On Demand pay-per-view. Riots, police, head cracks. It's all here and all real. It's Hooligans and Thugs, soccer's most violent fan fights. Playing this month on Dish On Demand pay-per-view.
There's no easier way to order Dish On Demand pay-per-view than with your remote control. Make sure your phone line is connected to your dish receiver and then use your remote to highlight the movie, sport, or event you want to order in the on-screen guide. Press the select button on your remote, follow the easy step-by-step instructions, and that's it. For the easiest way to order movies, sports, and events, use your remote tonight. Visit your pay-per-view channels and look for these great new movies available for the first time on television from Dish On Demand pay-per-view.
We haven't seen Jose Vargas in a while. That's why. Three fouls. John Williams and Derek Taylor also playing with three. And Doug Lee, the aggressive Boilermaker, has a three spot of his own. So right now it's Purdue with the advantage in that department and a four-point lead with 12:47 remaining. John Williams on the night, only 8 points, none of them since halftime.
It looked as if when Lee got his third foul that Redden started really trying to take it to him, but Lee played the good defense and has not picked up the fourth foul.
Well, Joe, you and
I up against each other.
You and I talked about it late in the first half when Melvin McCants went out of there. Troy Lewis and Todd Mitchell would have to do it for Purdue. They have, and Doug Lee has been consistent throughout the ball game. Oh, Todd Mitchell.
And from the
stuffing
weak side,
Williams.
Williams beat Arnold, but all of a sudden from the weak side came Mitchell. Look at it again. Right there, you see him beat Arnold? He looks like he's wide open for the layup. Here comes Mitchell, great rejection.
Anthony Wilson, well short with it. Jeff Arnold clears the defensive board.
LSU not getting good shots, Purdue getting excellent shots. LSU man-to-man defensively.
Back door, Todd Mitchell. Tremendous body control over the top of Ricky Blenton, and Todd has 25.
You can see the momentum has definitely moved toward Purdue. They're making a lot of things happen right now, and
John,
it's all good.
Williams under pressure. Todd Mitchell rebounding.
Williams can't hit in tight, and Purdue is really getting good shots.
Troy Lewis fouled, and that's number four on Derek Taylor.
Of course, if they lose him, they do not have a lot of point guard backup. And all Purdue did was push it up the court very, very quickly. And all of a sudden, Derek Taylor. Watch it again on the alley-oop, though. Great pass by Stevens. Who else? Mitchell. Right there above Blanton. Beautiful. Mitchell has only missed one shot all night. He's now 9 of 10. And the Boilermakers are playing fantastic right now. Williams of LSU just 4 of 15, not having the great night.
Todd Mitchell 6'7", Ricky Blanton 6'6". It looked like there was 4 or 5 inches between their heights on that last jump. Todd went way up. Troy Lewis missing from the outside.
Purdue moved the ball so well that time and got the shot they wanted for Troy Lewis out of the right side. He just couldn't get it to go.
Dale Brown concerned.
He has to be.
Well, you have the home court advantage. You're expected to win. He said he didn't feel any extra pressure because of that. But maybe now his answer would be a little bit different.
Oh, close. Derek Taylor tried to take it all the way. It could have been a charge, and if it would, it would have been all for Derek Taylor. Look at it again. He's whipped Stevens right here. Right. He's got, look at the defensive position. Oh, I'll tell you, it is a close call. Because from here, it looked like that Mitchell had position.
It certainly did.
And Derek Taylor is going to shoot two.
Troy Lewis has a seat. Derek Taylor at the line where he shoots 88%.
Bob, I thought they missed it. I thought Mitchell had great defensive position, and that's a big turnaround because that fouls Derek Taylor out of the game. He really gambled trying to take it to the basket. Instead, Derek Taylor is an excellent free throw shooter. You see the percentages. He can close the gap back to four.
He does. Everett Stevens was in on that play defensively. It's possible that he may have blocked the official's view of Todd Mitchell and what he was doing.
Possible. LSU zoning.
Everett Stevens against Anthony Wilson. Matt Gattis back on top to him. Purdue does not have a couple of great shooting guards without Troy Lewis in the game. There's a steal by Redden after the pressure. Out of bounds, belongs to LSU.
Underneath official couldn't pick it up. He asked for help. LSU got a steal out of that zone defense, one of the few steals they've had. Gene Cady shaking his head because the officials didn't seem to know what was happening.
Rick Taylor driving again. High off the glass, and he got it to fall. Taylor has 16. It's a two-point game. Purdue 55-53.
They got the crowd back in it all of a sudden. Purdue needs patience. You get the good shot.
Look out, Matt Gattis. You're about to be trapped. Redden knocked that ball out of bounds, and it might be a good thing for Purdue he did, because I believe a five-second call was just about to come.
Had to be close. They had him trapped. Of course, when LSU is in this type of zone defense, anytime they can use the baseline, they'll trap. Of course, most of these teams do. We're in that kind of a zone defense.
Troy Lewis is back in the game for Purdue. LSU drew back closely with him out of the game. Everett Stevens, the man sitting down. Four starters in there for Purdue. The only one not is the one at the hospital, Melvin McCants, with what we are told is a severely sprained ankle. He left late in the first half. The Boilers have played magnificently without him since. And the Boilermakers, what a timeout. 9:48 remaining in the ball game. Purdue 55-53. This one is close and intense in Baton Rouge.
See this group of smoking hot chicks just shot down guy number 6. But to get the ladies, all you need to unveil is your four-legged buddy with his 9-inch tail. Wing dog makes pickup lines disappear. If he could hold one, you'd buy him a beer. Wing dog.
Unleash the Rocky Mountain cold taste of Coors Light.
Did you catch the game last night?
Great game.
Yeah. Hey, what'd you have to eat?
Pound of beer battered chicken strips and cheese fries.
You? Oh, watercress tea sandwich with just a sprig of parsley.
Shoulda had a Hungry Man Sports Grill. A whole pound of the sports grill grub men love. Hungry Man, it's good to be full.
For the best protection against water damage, one name says it all. Thompson's Water Seal, waterproofer plus wood protector for the highest level of water protection guaranteed. Thompson's Water Seal and Thompson's Water Seal Advanced, the most powerful protection against water damage.
Hitman Jimmy the Tula is sensitive.
I just vacuumed this rug.
Oz is scared.
I need your help.
And Laszlo is mad.
Where's Yimmy?
Bruce Willis, Matthew Perry, The Whole 10 Yards. Rated PG-13. Starts Friday, April 9th.
Reggie Jackson here to tell you that the best way ever to improve your hitting just got even better. It's the new Hitaway title series.
Hitaway has helped more than a million batters improve their balance, timing, hand-eye coordination, muscle memory, and power mechanics through the simple process of repetitive hitting. A million hitters said no more chasing balls, no more batting cages. And now the new improved title series takes a revolution in training even farther.
I know a thing or two about titles, and here are five reasons you shouldn't take another swing without the Hitaway title series.
The Hitaway title series is more adjustable, more durable, engineered for better pacing. The ball is made with top grain leather, and a new sleeve design gives you better visibility and the best contact feel ever. Hitaway attaches easily to a tree or pole, indoors or out.
The Hitaway title series makes practicing easier than ever. It's great to be a singles hitter, but it's even better to be a doubles hitter.
The Hitaway title series for baseball or softball is yours for $29.95. Call in the next 10 minutes and you'll also get a Gorilla Gold grip enhancer and a pair of genuine leather batting gloves free. Or order online at hitaway.com, where you can also get a portable Hitaway pole or Hitaway tennis. Act now before this offer is long gone.
The only way to stay on top is to keep getting better. So be your best ever with the Hitaway title series.
On the next Cheap Seats.
Let's beat it up, y'all!
Randy and Jason look back at the brutal sport of spelling.
I love him! I know! He's like a mini mad Hungarian.
And it's not pretty.
She's got the answers sticking in her fingers.
10 p.m. Wednesday on ESPN Classic.
John Wooden, Rick Pitino, two legendary coaches, back to back. Sports Century John Wooden premieres at 8 p.m. tonight, followed by the premiere of Sports Century Rick Pitino at 8:30, only on ESPN Classic.
The Tigers' practice gym this week is doubling as the media room here at LSU. There's a sign down there, Joe, that says, when you're through improving, you're through. This one is a long way from being through. This is anybody's ball game right now.
Gene Cady wanted to make sure that he had things organized because he feels definitely LSU is going to go down the stretch in a zone defense with so many foul problems. And I'm sure he wanted to say, hey, let me talk to you. Let's get some things set up very, very well. But all of a sudden, LSU switched defenses and has gone man-to-man defensively. I'm surprised.
They also have a new player in the game, Nebojša Vukomitović. He's a 6'4 sophomore from Belgrade, Yugoslavia. On the miss by Troy Lewis, here comes Don Redden. Here's Ricky Blanton, left side for Anthony Wilson. Vukomitović is giving some resting time to Derek Taylor. So Anthony Wilson knows he must pick up the slack. He ties the ball game.
Williams has had a tough night inside, but that defense has really collapsed on him, and Arnold has really done a very good job defensively inside against Big John Williams.
It's going to be a great 9 minutes.
LSU back man-to-man again.
Matt Gattis for Doug Lee. Diving with the play to knock it out of bounds is Don Redden. And if the thigh's giving him any problems, he hasn't showed it here tonight.
Luckily posted up deep. Redden beat him to the ball, knocked it out of bounds.
In fact, if you look at the right leg of Don Redden, he's either very bruised or very dirty. I think those are bruises on the side of his leg from being down on the floor. Look at Todd Mitchell.
What a game. What an effort. He took it away from Big John Williams and just came back. And what I like, he jammed it on the glass. And their coach is saying, hey, fire up. We've got a ball game on our hands. Let's work. He really came to play.
John Williams over Jeff Arnold.
LSU must get it to him deep, because I think he can handle Arnold, because Arnold will definitely have to have some help. When he's gotten it further out in the court, they've had good defensive pressure.
John is too quick for Jeff. He has 10. That was his first basket of the second half.
He's been shooting short all night.
Doug Lee.
Beautiful basket.
He's a sniper.
He wasn't afraid.
16.
Wasn't afraid to put it up, Bob. He'd missed a few, came right back and got the big basket. They're doing a good job of picking down and swinging their jump shooters over the top for the good shot.
Don Redden looking to tie. Rebound, Doug Lee. Williams shook it away. Anthony Russell.
John Williams made the big save underneath.
Doug Lee never saw him. 59 each with 7.5 minutes remaining.
I'm surprised LSU's in the man defense. But they took Derek Taylor out, so now they're gambling.
Troy Lewis for Doug Lee. Jeff Arnold for Todd Mitchell, who's had a great tournament tonight. Troy Lewis driving, and Anthony Wilson got him for his second foul.
He just took him one-on-one. They cleared it out, gave him some operating room. That was the fourth team foul against LSU, but he was shooting, and he'll shoot two. It's an excellent free throw shooter. Over 81% on the year.
Troy Lewis has 11. Shoots 81% from the line. Good looking sophomore. He was a basketball and academic All-American at Anderson, Indiana, where he was co-Mr. Basketball in that b-ball crazed state.
Oh, it's one of the great hotbeds.
Well, I tell you, that Sunday afternoon that Purdue played Indiana at home, the state came to a halt.
I grew up in Indiana, Bob, and played high school basketball in Indiana, so I know the feeling.
And boy, did the Boilermakers put on a show against the Hoosiers at home that day. Ooh, nice jumper, left side, Anthony Wilson. He has 10. We're simply trading baskets. Edging down to the end of this one, 61 each.
We got an old-fashioned barn burner, as they say.
This is Jeff Arnold for Troy Lewis. Doug Lee's had a great night, but he's short that time. Anthony Wilson lost it to Jeff Arnold. Thank you, says Jeff. It's Christmas in March.
Total gift.
Arnold has a half dozen.
Purdue zoning.
Anthony Wilson.
Red hot. He is sizzling, and they must put pressure out there on him.
Gene Cady thinking to himself, hey, I thought if we got Derek Taylor out of the game, we'd have it made in the shade. But now Mr. Wilson is becoming a factor.
Purdue in a 1-4 offensive set with good motion.
This is Troy Lewis over Wilson.
Oh, I tell you, when they have to have it, Mitchell, Lewis, Lee, they deliver.
They call it TNT in West Lafayette, and that means Troy and Todd. They're roommates, they're sophomores, they're going to be great players. Look at that pass underneath. But Todd Mitchell broke it up. Purdue now with a chance to go up by 4.
They're trying to spread the court a little bit and work the clock. Interesting.
The shot clock has been, well, really nothing we've talked about in this game.
Shot clock is down to 15.
Matt Gattis against Nebojša Vukomitović, whose last name is so long they put his first name on the back of his shirt. There's John Williams. This guy can lead the fast break. Tipped away. Nicely done. Matt Gattis flipped that ball out of bounds. It'll belong to the Tigers. Vukomitović has a seat. Back into the ball game is Derek Taylor. How many guys 6'8 can lead a fast break?
Not many, and he does it well.
45 remaining. Purdue by two, but LSU with a chance to equalize here.
It has gone back man to man now.
Williams and Arnold having a war. Todd Mitchell just waiting to help out. There's the jumper from outside. Anthony Wilson, don't shake hands with him. You might get burnt.
They're collapsing on John Williams when the ball goes inside, and he's just shoving it back out, and Anthony Wilson's bringing it home. LSU now in a 2-3 zone.
The 14,000-plus making some noise.
Dean Katie shouting instructions to make sure they understand the defensive change.
I hope they can read lips because you can't hear anything in here.
Lewis is the one directing traffic.
Back at us for Doug Lee. Rebound Redden and a foul by Todd Mitchell, and that's number four.
And it's 15 foul now against Purdue. I liked what he did, though. He was going to that offensive board. He's done it so well all night long. It looked like the momentum had totally swung to Purdue, but they let Derek Taylor get loose in a big questionable call on him that could have been the fifth. It went for LSU, and it sort of changed the momentum since that time. Purdue back man-to-man.
Timeout by Dale Brown. 3:50 remaining in the basketball game. We're tied 65 all, and we're headed for a great finish here amongst some of the scenery in Baton Rouge.
Here we go, steal down the middle. 101.
Did you see what I see? Because I saw a robber. Does anybody want a Coke?
Yeah.
Hey, you crazy, man? That's Corinthian leather. And use the footstool to get to the refrigerator.
I'm running all over y'all like a treadmill.
I am the greatest.
I'm the greatest. Can't stop it. It's bad hot. I'm telling you. I'm just super nice in it, you know? That's all. When you nice like
that's like a dish towel.
Come in now to Sears. It's the best time to buy lawn gear at the lowest prices of the season. The Craftsman Lawn Ace mower with a fresh start system. The Lawn Tamer tractor powered by 18-horsepower Briggs & Stratton engine. Both at the lowest prices of the season. Sears has gear experts who'll fix you up with the right products at a great price. Hurry in for the lowest prices of the season, because right now is the best time to buy lawn gear, and you deserve the good life. Sears. Good life. Great price.
My job keeps me hopping and on the road all the time, so I know hotels. And that's why I stay at Extended Stay America. I'm not cramped. It's value. I get a full kitchen so I can cook my own meals. There's a place where I can do a little work, even a recliner where I can just relax. And check out the price.
Everything I need, great price. That's real value.
And I get it at Extended Stay America. Why would I stay anywhere else?
That's it. Thank you, everyone.
Really great loan offers.
Remember, no points.
Okay.
Bye.
We'll let you know.
I think we got some pretty good mortgage offers there.
Yeah. Of course, we still need to pick a realtor.
The realtors.
Now at LendingTree.com, you can find a mortgage and a realtor all in one place. Call now at 1-800-555-TREE.
Sorry about that, guys.
We got a four-bedroom.
You can now view detailed listings of homes for sale in your area that meet your specific needs. And for a limited time, you can get up to a $2,000 gift card to the Home Depot when you close with a realtor certified by LendingTree. Just fill out one simple form and choose the mortgage and the realtor that's right for you. Act now and take advantage of our $2,000 gift card offer to the Home Depot. Call LendingTree at 1-800-555-TREE.
He's sitting on 714.
So historic.
Here's the pitch by Downing.
So heroic.
It's gone! It's 715!
So much more than a number.
There's a new home run champion of all time, and it's Henry Aaron.
30 years ago, one swing changed everything.
What a marvelous moment for the country and the world.
Remembering 715, all day April 8th, starting at 11:30 on ESPN Classic.
They're doing the wave, at least attempting to do it here at LSU. They've been making some noise. We've got 3:50 remaining. The winner of this game will play Memphis State. The Tigers hammered the Cardinals of Ball State here earlier this evening. Georgia Tech and Villanova, the afternoon winner, Rangers here in Baton Rouge. They'll match it up on Saturday.
Memphis State really look tough, so whoever wins, they've got their hands full.
And if it's Purdue, they'll have to go against William Bedford without their starting center.
What a blow.
And for LSU, a team without a true center, they'll have to go against the seven-footer. John Williams almost taken away by Everett Stevens. The foul called. That's 16 fouls on Purdue in the second half.
So from this point on, LSU will be in the bonus. LSU's only committed 14 fouls. Well, they can waste two more.
That could be a big factor.
With 3:36, it could be very big.
65 each. It was a four-point LSU spread at the half, 39-35. Purdue came back strong early in the second half. Has led in this ballgame a couple of times by six, but unable to deliver the knockout punch. Anthony Wilson, this is Ricky Blanton. He's been reluctant to be much involved in the offense tonight. Taylor, and then Blanton.
Good
Ricky
block.
Has six.
Against Taylor, they blocked it, but a lucky bounce went right to Ricky Blanton for the lay-in. Purdue shooting 50% for the game. LSU 49.
Troy Lewis and Everett Stevens. Troy gunning from long range, and it's too long. Here's Derek Taylor for John Williams against Everett Stevens.
One-on-one, John Stevens. I mean, big John Williams. Kind of a breakaway basket. Good body control.
Dale Brown up on his feet with arms raised.
Big. Ooh. Big. I'm just getting ready to say, Bob, Purdue needed a real good shot. And they gambled on a long bomb, but they got it to go.
From a guy who hadn't hit all night.
That's exactly right. It scared me for Purdue.
Think you were scared. How do you think Gene Cady felt?
He said no, and then he sat down and said yay.
There's a steal momentarily by Stevens, but Williams got it back. Derek Taylor back in there running the offense with the 20-footer. Rebound, Jeff Arnold. Williams took it away, but swats it out of bounds. Purdue's got to be a little more alert when they defensively rebound because John Williams is lurking in there, slapping at the ball.
And remember, LSU's only committed 14 fouls. They could gamble just a little bit. They're in a zone. It's a 2-3.
A minute 50 remaining. 2 points the spread in favor of LSU. Todd Mitchell just escapes in time. Troy Lewis for Everett Stevens. Very deliberate, the Boilers are here. Air ball. Todd Mitchell saves it. Jeff Arnold.
What a save. Unbelievable. Looks like LSU quit playing.
I think they thought the air ball was going to harmlessly bounce into the seats. And just like that, we're tied at 69.
LSU completely quit playing underneath. What a save by Mitchell.
That's what you call an ABA, an air ball assist.
Unbelievable. And Purdue is zoning. 2-3.
A minute five remaining. Dale Brown says, let's talk about it. LSU, timeout. 65 seconds remaining on the court. It's a 69-69 score. LSU has the ball. We'll be back with more from the Southeast Regional.
Quick, in the top five water polo players in the world. Okay, how about one? Yeah. I didn't start playing water polo to get famous. And the same goes for being a biology major. I like working in protein chemistry.
Quick, name the top five protein chemists in the world.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Just when Jimmy and Jill and Oz and Cynthia think they're out of trouble with the mob.
Oh! Try not to shoot Oz, honey.
They pull them back in.
Where is my wife?
Bruce Willis, Matthew Perry, the whole 10 yards. Rated PG-13. Starts Friday, April 9th.
Who are you?
I'm with the Sons Without Dads organization. Who are you?
I'm his dad.
Spending too much time on home improvement projects? Come into Ace, the helpful place.
The NCAA Women's Basketball Championship. Connecticut versus Penn State at 7. LSU versus Georgia at 9. Tonight on ESPN.
Pick me out a winner, Bobby.
ESPN Classic presents Robert Redford and an all-star cast. The Natural, the movie, and an inside look from real sports legends. 8 Eastern Sunday on ESPN Classic.
Every time you smoke a cigarette, you're taking 7 to 11 minutes off your life. For the typical smoker, that can be as much as 10 years. You're nearly twice as likely to die of heart disease and almost 3 times more likely to die of cancer. By the age of 45, your lung function has already declined at 3 times the normal rate. If you're ready to quit smoking, we can help. We're the makers of Smoke Away, a doctor-recommended program developed to eliminate your cravings and have you smoke-free in just 7 days. It's all natural and nicotine-free. And best of all, it's guaranteed to work or your money back. Call us today. Thousands have already quit using Smoke Away. Shouldn't you?
I know it worked the first day for me. I quit overnight.
The first time I used it, I felt the cravings just go away.
Call 1-800-903-1823. That's 1-800-903-1823.
You're going to see the replay on the great save by Mitchell. Here's Stevens shooting an air ball. It almost looked like it hit the out-of-bounds line, but the official was right there, said no. LSU kind of quit playing. And it was an unbelievable save and great hustle. Watch this by Mitchell. LSU kind of quits. He kicks it to Arnold. He's wide open underneath, and this game is tied with 105.
What a play to tie the game in a crucial situation.
And can you believe that Stevens put it up? He hit one. He hasn't been shooting well.
Yeah, they didn't. It's not like he had 5 seconds on the shot clock to shoot. There was a fat 20 sitting up there.
And the shot clock is almost down now to 15 for LSU.
It's one thing about young players. They have to understand their role on the team, Joe, and that's not his role to take that shot. That's for Troy Lewis and for Todd Mitchell.
Shot clock now, problem.
5 seconds or less. Taylor misses. Rebound, Blanton. Who's going to get it? It's Purdue, Everett Stevens. Now, the shot clock. Not a factor.
Not a factor. They'll hold it for the last shot.
And the Boilers are in position to win it with 29 seconds remaining. And the score tied at 69.
Good defense by Purdue on Derek Taylor. The shot clock was running down on them. He tried to take it to the right side. The defense was perfect. Looked like maybe they even got a little piece of the ball against him. And Stevens touched it loose underneath. Looked like LSU had it, but all of a sudden, it was a big stack underneath there, and Stevens came away with it.
Joe, Dick Vitale, and others have been talking at great length about the effect of the shot clock on the tournament this year. Your thoughts?
Well, in watching games last year with Villanova, you know, they spread the court a lot, made you come and chase. The shot clock does change things a little bit because the defense can sit back. If they want a zone, they can sit back and kind of do what they want to do. So there's a little bit of difference. And you won't see a team be able to tempo the game quite as much as you saw last year like a Villanova did. But boy, we've had a hoodie here. Both teams have played so hard.
The Boilers of the Big Ten finishing in a fourth place tie with Illinois. The LSU Tigers 11-3 in the home part of their season, 9-9 in the SEC, and they were 6-3. All three of those losses came at home in conference play.
Big factor here, Bob. Purdue has committed 6 fouls, which means LSU in the bonus. LSU's only committed 4 fouls so far this half. With 29 ticks left on the clock, LSU can gamble for the steal. If they get it, great. If they don't, all Purdue will do will take the ball out of bounds again. They can do it twice. And LSU is going to line up man-to-man defensively.
69 all, 29 seconds remaining. Doug Lee gets it in for Everett Stevens. You've got to be thinking Troy Lewis or Todd Mitchell.
They need to go after the ball. Gamble, they can waste 2 fouls.
Don Redden reaching around, that's one of them.
Good try, though. 17 seconds.
His first. So much riding on these last few seconds. A date with Memphis State on Saturday at stake. And now LSU wants to talk about defense. We'll take a timeout as well with 17 seconds remaining. The score tied at 69. Boilers with the ball. LSU with the defensive strategy.
A
America's favorite home gym is more affordable than ever. Now you can get the all-new Bowflex Extreme for just $19 a month. Call the number on your screen for a free DVD or video and check it out. Bowflex designed the Extreme to give you a total body workout in just 20 minutes. Losing weight and building muscle is more effective than ever. When you're ready to get in shape, Bowflex Power Rod technology delivers real results. Powerful arms, defined legs, a stronger heart, and a toned sexy core. You can perform more than 65 gym quality exercises, but at a price much lower than your health club dues. Great results are easy with a new Extreme. All it takes is one simple workout, 20 minutes a day, three times a week, to get in the best shape of your life. The Extreme is built so well that we back it with an unrivaled 7-year warranty. And so effective, it comes with Bowflex's 100% satisfaction guarantee. Through this special offer, you can own one with no money down and just $19 per month. You can't get this Bowflex deal anywhere else. Call now and get chiseled abs, rock hard biceps, and well-defined lines for just $19 a month. You know you're ready. It's time to let Bowflex help you get there. Join over 1 million people who have already experienced Bowflex and get the results you have always wanted. Every Bowflex Extreme comes standard with a lat tower, a squat platform, adjustable seat, and an incredibly versatile pulley system that adjusts to your body type, allowing you to perform more than 65 body sculpting exercises. And thanks to our $19 a month offer, owning your very own Bowflex home gym is more affordable than ever. Call us for a free DVD or video, or visit us online and find out how to get your Bowflex for just $19 a month today. Bowflex, because your results matter.
How do you spell cutthroat?
C-A-E-N-N-E.
No!
Wednesday.
Let's beat up, y'all!
Randy and Jason look back at the brutal sport of spelling.
I love him! I know! He's like a mini mad Hungarian.
And it's not pretty. Get ready for a Cinderella story that'll leave you spellbound.
Don't you see, people? She's got the answers hidden in her fingers.
In all new Cheap Seats, without these guys, sports would just be sports. 10 p.m. Wednesday on ESPN Classic.
It'll be very interesting to see, Joe, when we come back to play here with 17 seconds remaining, how soon Purdue will go into running its offense. Some teams make the critical mistake of going in too early.
With 10 seconds, so they got to start kind of getting into some flow and getting some action. They can't wait any longer than that. These are two great programs, and both these teams have just played their hearts out. LSU's gone to 7 straight postseason tournaments. Purdue's gone to 8 straight, and Purdue's won 16 conference championships.
And you've got to know that somewhere here in Baton Rouge, radio is tuned in, and Melvin McCants, with his ankle being x-rayed, is probably listening in to see if his teammates can pull it off without him.
Heartbreaking loss for Purdue.
Doug Lee gets it in for Stevens, and a near steal by Derek Taylor.
Gamble
1 second off the clock.
Gamble by Taylor because he has 4 fouls.
But the team foul situation not that serious. Only 5 for LSU. They've got 1 to play with. Doug Lee gets it in for Everett Stevens.
Purdue trying to spread the court. LSU can waste 1 more foul. They need to go for it now.
Troy Lewis with the turnaround, way short. We may be going to overtime if Redden cannot hit here. A foul! A foul! Or was there a foul? No, the official blew his whistle, raised his arm, but said, we're going to overtime. I tell you, Joe, he looked like he was signaling foul.
I don't know, but I thought he was too. Let's look at it again. Not a good shot by Purdue. You see the clock ticking. Redden of LSU has the ball. Let's watch it now.
Watch the official below the, at the bottom of your screen. He had his hand up before the scoreboard reached 0, and we thought he had signaled a foul on this shot. That would have been a devastating blow to Purdue, but now we're headed to OT.
On the replay, though, it didn't look like Mitchell touched him. He just ran by him and had his hand in the air because he didn't want to touch him and take that kind of a chance.
Wow. Extra session here. Clock set for 5 minutes. That's how they spell go down here, by the way.
That's what they tell me, G-E-A-U-X. Go Tigers. One side saying go, and the other side Tigers. And of course, the Boilermaker right there, he's tried desperately to lead cheers, but he's been outnumbered.
That's Pat Cady right to the left of your screen, the coach's wife.
Jean Cady in his sixth year at Purdue. 124 wins and 59 losses. What a job he's done. He's from Kansas originally, and he coached at Hutchinson Junior College, Western Kentucky, and he's been successful at every stop. He's with Eddie Sutton a few years, who is now the head coach at the University of Kentucky. He was at Arkansas for 4 years. And remember, Purdue's playing without their big guy, Melvin McCants. And we hope it's not a broken ankle. At the end of regulation, LSU shot 47.8%, Purdue 49.2%, both under team averages a little bit for the year. The defense was hard-nosed, and they got after it.
5 minutes on the clock. The jump ball, John Williams and Todd Mitchell, just like it was about an hour and 45 minutes ago. Jeff Arnold got a touch, kept it alive for Troy Lewis, and now Edward Stevens for Purdue. And they're back in a zone, are the Tigers.
2-3. They've changed defenses a lot. Hey, one thing about Edward Stevens, he has not been bashful in critical situations to put up that jump shot.
Todd Mitchell, baseline right, got open behind Don Redden, but hit it short. John Williams cleared the board.
I like the shot they got. They got a real good shot. That's only the second shot. Mitchell has missed the entire game. Purdue is man-to-man defensively.
Don Redden called for the foul, trying to set a pick for John Williams.
And he moved as he set the pick. 16 foul against LSU. He can't move on the pick. He set the pick, but he started moving, and that's when they trapped him.
Look at the bruises on Don Redden's leg. Up and down, black and blue. He's had some deep thigh bruises and deep leg bruises lately. Back playing. Only one other overtime game in the NCAA today. Temple beat Jacksonville 61-50. There's Troy Lewis. He has 16 on the night.
Tough shot deep in that right side, but he got it to go down. Big basket. Take that lead in the overtime. Purdue now zoning.
Here's where the shot clock has a big effect in overtime, Joe, because coaches love to hold the ball in OT.
That's right. They work a lot of clock.
Don Redden slapped away. Everett Stevens and Todd Mitchell teaming up on the play.
Redden had the shot. Instead of taking it, tried to put it on the floor, and they took it away from him. And Purdue's going to work the clock now, just like you called it.
3:05 in OT, so we're almost 2 minutes in.
Kind of dangerous with just a two-point lead, but the shot clock finally grabbed him.
Todd Mitchell tying his career high of 27 here tonight.
I'm sure they'd love for Lewis to put it up.
That one tipped out of bounds by the hustling Don Redden.
Big knock out of bounds there. Big defensive play because it cuts the shot clock down to 7. It will not be reset. Only with possession.
Doug Lee for Everett Stevens. Lee may have to gun it up there. Redden got him on the way up. They're out of time. Troy Lewis had a bit of a slip there mentally. Gene Cady thought there was a foul.
When the ball was kicked away the way it did, the players kind of lost a little concentration on the shot clock.
So right there, it has an effect.
Purdue 2-3 zone.
Boilers the only points of the OT. A field goal by Troy Lewis. John Williams in the paint, 12 feet away.
Yeah,
Don Redden stripped it right away from Todd Mitchell. He has 19.
It's been this way all the way. The biggest lead by either team was six. Each team led by six.
Everett Stevens from 19, the sophomore.
What courage.
He hasn't hit much tonight. In fact, a long field goal from that range late in the game in regulation was his first of the night, and that was his second. With Purdue leading 73-71, it is Dale Brown calling timeout on the court, and we'll be back with more overtime in just a moment.
There are two sides to me. The all-conference catcher side, that's my tough side. And the side of me studying for a career in marine mammal rescue, that's my soft side. I'm finding I really need both sides to be the whole person that I want to be.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
He was brought over from the dark side.
Something may have come through. Hellboy.
But a secret government agency raised him to fight for our side.
He's born a demon, but you will help him to become a man.
Now, evil has something to fear. One of its own.
Skip to the end. How do I kill it?
Hellboy. Rated PG-13. Opens everywhere Friday.
Baseball's back. Now relive the greatest games from the 2003 playoffs, plus the story behind the curse of the Babe and the Billy Goat. All day Sunday. Then at 7 p.m., the ESPN original documentary, only on ESPN Classic.
John Wooden, Rick Pitino, two legendary coaches, back to back. Sports Century John Wooden premieres at 8 p.m. tonight, followed by the premiere of Sports Century Rick Pitino at 8:30, only on ESPN Classic.
When you leave here, you'll be lean, mean, computer-buying machines. I'll give you the skills, the smarts,
hard drive, CPU,
and the courage.
I do not have to settle for what's on the shelf.
Your PC jargon has no effect on me.
It won't be easy. Drop down and give me 50. But you'll be able to buy a computer without getting ripped off and sit home crying to your mama.
Want an easier way to buy a PC? Don't go there. Go Dell. Forget all the mega this and giga that. Just tell Dell what you want to do with your PC in plain English. They'll build one that fits your life and your budget. Like this Dimension desktop with an Intel Pentium 4 processor. It's just $499 after mail-in rebate. And right now, pay no interest until April 2005 for well-qualified customers. Plus, get free shipping.
Why don't you just quit?
I still don't know how to format a hard drive.
Your perfect PC, easy as Dell.
Dell PCs use Intel Pentium 4 processor.
We'd like to take this opportunity this evening to thank our tournament manager, Jeff Elliott, the tournament media coordinator, Jamie Kimbrough, the athletic director from Purdue, George King, head basketball coach, Gene Cady, his staff, and sports information director, Jim Brugink. And from LSU, athletic director, Bob Broadhead, basketball coach, Dale Brown, his staff, and SID, Jamie Kimbrough. Transportation arrangements made through Fugazi International Travel, the official travel agency for the NCAA championships. 90 seconds left. LSU down by two with the ball. Don Redden.
Purdue has switched away from that zone and gone man-to-man defensively.
Derek Taylor for John Williams. Against Jeff Arnold. We're tied again. 14 for John Williams, who averages 18 a game.
Hadn't been the big night for him, but he's had a couple of baskets when they were so big. LSU man-to-man defensively now.
I think one of the big stories is he hasn't been able to take advantage more of the absence of Melvin McCants.
I think Purdue's done a good job of collapsing on him when the ball has gone inside and they've forced him out. He has not been able to get the ball really on the low post. So give credit to Gene Cady and the Purdue Boilermakers for really doing an excellent defensive job against John Williams.
Timeouts remaining. Purdue still has three. After calling that one with 58 seconds remaining in the 73-73 game, the winner takes on Memphis State.
Georgia Tech will meet Villanova. Georgia Tech beat Marist College of Poughkeepsie, New York by 15 this afternoon. Villanova handled Virginia Tech. And then it was Memphis State easily over Ball State earlier this evening.
They were impressive. There's 58 seconds left in this overtime period. There's 29 seconds left on the shot clock. So Purdue, who has possession when we come back, has 29 ticks of that clock to get the good percentage cut. And I'm sure Gene Katie wants to make sure it's a good one. Stevens has been putting it up, but I would think he would like it to be Troy Lewis. Or if not Lewis, Todd Mitchell, maybe in low.
One thing to keep in mind as we go down the stretch here, LSU is a better free throw shooting team than Purdue. And the Tigers have some great stats of guys who can hit from the line late in the game. They're clutch performers from the stripe. In fact, in the last 4 minutes of regulation games throughout the season, LSU normally hits at an 81% clip as a team.
They were man-to-man. Now looks like they're going to go back zone. They are going to go back 2-3. Well, they've made a lot of defensive changes, but Purdue's picked them up very well, I think.
Troy Lewis for Everett Stevens. Doug Lee back to the point guard. Uh-oh, Don Redden. That was a high-risk pass from Everett Stevens to Troy Lewis.
LSU can now hold it for the last shot.
They call timeout. 40 seconds remaining. You've got a sophomore in there as a point guard, Joe Dean, instead of your senior, Matt Gattis. And that was a mistake by the sophomore with an easily intercepted pass to the baseline.
He tried to throw it across two people. A lot of times you can get away with one, but he tried too much distance across there. Don Redden, with excellent anticipation, picked it off. There's 40 seconds left in this game. We're going to show you the interception again. Right here. Here comes Gattis with the pass. You can see he's throwing it across too far, too deep. That's the 15th turnover by Purdue. They had 10 in the first half, just 5 in the second half. Right here.
You see, Don Redden was covering Todd Mitchell.
I thought he skipped two men. He just really skipped to Lee, trying to get it to the corner.
Redden covering one man, saw the pass, left him, and went to the ball.
LSU has no timeouts left. But they can now hold it for the last shot. Shot clock is off.
40 seconds remaining in overtime.
Purdue can't afford to get too aggressive defensively because, remember, as you mentioned, Bob, LSU's in the bonus, and LSU's an excellent free throw shooting team.
Dale Brown has had some amazing things to say about this team. They lost junior guard Dennis Brown and junior forward Nikita Wilson to grades. Sophomore center Zoran Jovanovic to a knee injury and chicken pox. Then, of course, there was the Tito Horford debacle. And he said that there is more fire in me the last few weeks than in a long time, Dale Brown. He says, I have spent my career motivating young men. He said, this team, coming back from adversity and losing all those players, has motivated me.
And they say he's been much calmer this year. Purdue, man-to-man defensively.
We'll see if they can motivate him into the next round against Memphis State. Everett Stevens tipping it away.
Oh, he gambled, didn't get it, but almost.
Each team has 6 fouls. Next foul will result in free throws.
That's why I was a little surprised he'd go for the steal. He can't gamble that much.
John Williams cradling it, waiting for his point guard to break open. Derek Taylor unable to. Everett Stevens all over him. 20 seconds remaining in this tie in overtime. John Williams, one of the few big men in the nation that can dribble well enough and handle the ball well enough to start the offense here.
You see the clock.
There's his move. Doug Lee has it. We're going to another overtime session unless Purdue, after calling this timeout, can make something happen with 1 second left. And the Purdue bench is claiming that there were 2 seconds left when they called the timeout.
LSU had an unbelievably great shot. John Williams simply went one-on-one against Arnold. He just could not get it to go. It has not been John Williams' great night shooting the basketball. He got iron, it came out, and with 1 second, Purdue gained possession.
Oh,
Smart move by the Boilermakers. They had no chance to get it down the floor. It right was here. A good shot.
Unbelievably great shot. Look where he is. Deep in the paint right here. An easy shot. It gets the back of the iron and comes out. Bodies are everywhere. I mean, it's tenacious underneath. But LSU had the shot they wanted. He probably should have gone to the glass with it because you're in so tight, Bob. It's a very, very, I think, one of the toughest shots in the game, about 5 feet. And if you don't, you've got to have the delicate touch. If you put it on the board, you eliminate some of that touch. Just jam it on the glass.
Interesting to see what Purdue will come up with here. With 1 second remaining in the first overtime.
And they have to go 3/4 of the length of the court. LSU can't foul. Remember, they've committed 6 as well, so they're in the bonus.
Gene Cady upset about his seeding in the tournament, having to play LSU on the Tigers' home floor. And then having to stare in the face of another set of Tigers if he wins this one, Memphis State. Doug Lee is walking down the court to take the inbounds pass.
I said 3/4 of the court. They're going to have to take it out underneath. So they've got to go the length of the court. They're just going to throw it.
Looks like they're going to try to set a pick for Todd Mitchell or for Troy Lewis. There's the touchdown pass. It's intercepted. Off the top of the glass there by Derek Taylor. And we're headed to another overtime. Tied at 73.
Double OT.
Wait. This is Daddy's, okay? This is my blizzard. No, this is Daddy's cheesecake, okay? This is not for babies. Stop. Yeah. See? That's why I'm Daddy.
The Cheesequake Blizzard treats from Dairy Queen in strawberry toffee and Oreo cookie with rich chunks of real cheesecake. They're worth fighting for. DQ, something different.
You got kids?
Teatro Greco, Taormina, Sicily. No power, no plugs, no wires. What a perfect place to connect. Because with a laptop powered by Centrino, Intel's mobile technology, you can put on quite a show wirelessly from your own private amphitheater. Intel Centrino, mobile technology.
Grab some body wash from Old Spice.
Put my love to the test.
It has a dual action formula, so you'll get really clean, smell really great.
Hey, Ben, need help with your anatomy homework?
Body wash from Old Spice.
The ESPN Classic Roadshow is live from San Antonio, site of this year's NCAA championship. Warm up for college basketball's biggest weekend with ESPN's Gary Miller.
What a lineup we have for you today.
Plus, Randy and Jason Sklar, hosts of Classic's offbeat comedy, Cheap Seats. Get ready for the NCAA championship with the ESPN Classic San Antonio Roadshow. We'll go live at 8 p.m. Eastern Friday, only on ESPN Classic. Brought to you locally by Time Warner Cable and presented naturally by Pennzoil.
2001.
Here it is. Swing! And the Arizona Diamondbacks! What in the world, cheering!
Classic.
Well, a lot of dancing going on here, but you've got to know that some of those folks are a little bit tight inside about the situation here. We've played 45 minutes. We're tied at 73. They'll set the clock for 5 more. Purdue had the first basket of that overtime coming from Troy Lewis. It was John Williams answering for LSU. 4 points for each team in OT. 73 each. Williams against Todd Mitchell, jumping it up for the 3rd time tonight. This time it's controlled by Anthony Wilson of LSU. That's the first jump the Tigers have controlled this evening. Redden baseline left. Rebound, Ricky Blanton.
Redden got loose on the baseline. He couldn't make it go, but Blanton, you say, why was he inside? He was because Purdue was zoning and nobody blocked him off. And Blanton, who has not shot the ball much out on the court, is 5 of 5, mostly on offensive boards.
The book on Ricky Blanton is he can score on the putbacks. Purdue forgot to read the book.
He's kind of the garbage man on this team.
Matt Gattis is in, by the way, at point guard for Purdue. Drilling from outside was Troy Lewis, unable to hit. And I think that's a significant move by Gene Cady, Joe Dean. He's got a senior in there now rather than the sophomore Everett Stevens.
I like that move, and I also like the shot they got. They got a good shot, just couldn't get it to go.
Eric Taylor has been playing a long time with four fouls, so credit him with sticking around. John Williams for Anthony Wilson. Oh, what a second half he has had. He's got 16 tonight, 12 of them since halftime.
Give John Williams a lot of credit. They took it inside. He just reversed the ball, and the defense just couldn't get to him quick enough.
Troy
Purdue needs a good shot.
Matt Gattis, the point guard, way short. Fast break. Anthony Wilson is the lead, 6. Purdue's got to have a timeout.
Bob, I think this crowd likes it. All of a sudden, it's erupted. They had kind of kept them a little bit at bay throughout, but because it's been so tight, and they've been on the edge of their seats, but they're starting to roar again now. Look at it again. John Williams, another rebound. He outlets the ball, and Anthony Wilson takes it. Right there, they tried to get the block. Lewis, he didn't want to foul, but Anthony Wilson wide open, lays it in, and the LSU lead is 6.
Unless something dramatic changes here in the last 3:27, it'll be the Tigers and Tigers on Saturday, Memphis and Louisiana State.
Anthony Wilson has 14 points in the second half on 7-8 shooting. I don't count Purdue out yet, though, Bob, because there's 3:27. They've been here before. You still got to shoot it in 45. Gene Cady still doing his job. He's got 2 timeouts left. The key is he's got to score a basket on this offensive set. They've got to get the good shot, and they've got to get it to go down. And LSU's in a 2-3 zone.
Everett Stevens back in, so Matt Gattis is out. He's been shuttling the point guards, Gene Cady has. Boy, you think back to a shot Todd Mitchell had in the first OT. Uh-oh, look out! Doug Lee saved it, but to LSU. No, he didn't save it. It went out of bounds. Hard to hear the whistles with the crowd. It belongs to the Tigers, who have a chance to go up by 8.
Tough break. He tried to throw it over the zone defense. He just made a bad pass. 17th turnover by Purdue. Full court pressure now by the Boilermakers. They need a steal. They need something cheap.
LSU 79-73. In 20 seconds, we'll be halfway through this overtime period. And we have a foul. It appears to be on Jeff Arnold, fouling Don Redden. And thus, one of the best free throw shooters in the SEC will go to the stripe.
I missed it. It was away from the ball. I couldn't pick it up.
Now they say it was on Doug Lee. Arnold has taken a seat. It doesn't matter because Redden's the man at the line, and he's the one that LSU wants at the line. Four for four tonight. He's 8 of 17 from the field. You just saw his 20th point.
And he has 8 rebounds in the game, which is surprising for him. He's almost 90% at the line. Of course, he's 4 for 4, as you saw there tonight.
Somebody better put a lasso on Jose Vargas over on the bench. He's going crazy right now. Dale Brown is excited. His team has opened up an 8-point lead here in overtime, and there's another turnover.
Purdue's just completely lost their poise now.
The Boilermakers are self-destructive.
They had to score the last 2 times, and they just have completely gone to pieces. They've thrown the ball away.
Don Redden gets it in for Derek Taylor. They get it over the line for Anthony Wilson. Look out! John Williams. This one is just about history now. 2:30 remaining. Purdue down by 10. They've got to make something amazing happen, and Doug Lee gets them started at least with that tough jumper. 8 points the spread. There's a steal by Herb Robinson. Troy Lewis for Everett Stevens, and Williams took it away.
Oh, they could have got a basket there. They still had a shot, but they made the bad pass again.
Foul. Troy Lewis.
Lee hit a basket, cut it to 8. They stole the ball, had the numbers, made a bad pass. And now John Williams will go to the line and shoot 1-1. They're still 2:09.
John Williams tonight just hasn't shot a free throw.
And he has not shot the ball well for him, Bobby. One of their really, truly great players, averaging 18 and a half points a game. He's been shooting 52% all year long. He's 8 of 21 tonight. And as you see there, 16 points. He has 7 rebounds.
Considering his health this week, a double overtime game was probably the last thing he needed. Thus, maybe the reason for the miss. Troy Lewis. Missing himself, Todd Mitchell skying, but there's Williams up above everyone. LSU by 8. Earlier this evening, I saw down the table to our left, Dana Kirk of Memphis State during the ball game here, doing a little radio with some of the guys, maybe a little analysis, scouting these two ball clubs.
After his game, we spoke just for a minute, Bob, and I said, who would you rather play? He said, give me Purdue. They may be a better club, but I don't want that crowd. And you really can't blame him and Coach Gene Cady. You saw there, he not real happy right now, and you can understand it.
Well, if you consider the home court advantage, Katie played LSU heads up for regulation, the overtime, and against someone else without the crowd, that probably would have been well enough to win.
No question. Derek Taylor at the line. He's been 7 of 14, 3 for 3 now at the line, and he's had 5 steals in this game. He's their point guard.
And remember that Derek has been around for a long time with 4 fouls.
And this is his 5th year as well.
He has 18. 10 points again the spread. 1:35 remaining. Everett Stevens. Herb Robinson foul. Anthony Wilson has it. Terrible things keep happening to the Boilermakers. And John Williams missed on a two-handed stuff. Alley-oop. Todd Mitchell from Everett Stevens. Redden took it away, but Williams fouled him from behind. Number 4 on Big John. Some of you folks watching up in the Purdue area, we know it's awfully late in the morning for you now.
Redden to John Williams. Watch the dunk that doesn't go right here. Wide open. Two-handed to try to get it to go, and it hits the backside and really gets out of it.
Todd Mitchell at the other end.
What a night this young man has had, though. I have really been impressed with Todd Mitchell. 10 of 12 from the field, only missed 2 field goal attempts all night. Super at the foul line on 8. Of 11, 28.7 boards.
That's a new career high for him. Derek Taylor drawing the foul. Herb Robinson.
Gene Cady was nervous about the draw. 2 out of the last 3 years, they've had to play somebody on their home court. I think year before last, they had to play Memphis State.
They were champions of the Big Ten that year.
And that's a tough draw to go to Memphis on their court, just like here.
Derek Taylor has 19. Some of the folks up in Indiana have had to stay up well past the midnight hour to watch this one, and it appears to be in vain.
Their team is going down, but I'll tell you this, what an effort. And they've seen a terrific college basketball game, double overtime.
Remember what I said earlier tonight. Next year, look out for Purdue in the Big Ten. Everybody back except for Matt Gattis in the starting role. There's Herb Robinson with the follow. And he has his first basket of the night as Gene Cady and Purdue called timeout. It's 87-78, 58 seconds remaining in the second overtime.
Old pals.
Don't shoot, it's us!
I know!
New problems.
Cynthia's been kidnapped.
And a rude awakening. Bruce Willis, Matthew Perry.
Thank God the killers are here.
The whole 10 yards, rated PG-13. Starts Friday, April 9th.
Ugh. Stop using messy athlete's foot cream. Try Gold Bond Foot Swabs, the maximum strength medicine you can trust. Snap to release the only medicine proven to cure and prevent most athlete's foot.
With no mess.
Gold Bond Foot Swabs, the no mess, no touch cure.
Is it true that you guys do more brake jobs than anyone else?
Yes.
And are my pads and shoes really guaranteed for as long as I own my car?
Yes.
Even if it's 20 more years?
Absolutely.
Do you ever cry at weddings?
No.
Visit your neighborhood Midas mechanic now for lifetime guaranteed brake pads or shoes. Just $89.95, including installation. Guaranteed for as long as you own your car. For mechanics known for their work and their word,
trust the Midas touch.
If a relaxing moment turns into the right moment, will you be ready? Introducing Cialis, the first tablet for erectile dysfunction that gives you up to 36 hours to choose the moment that's right for you and your partner. New Cialis goes to work fast and can work for up to 36 hours. Cialis is not for everyone. If you take nitrates for chest pain or certain alpha blockers for prostate problems or high blood pressure, do not take Cialis. Such combinations could cause a sudden unsafe drop in blood pressure. Don't drink alcohol in excess with Cialis. The most common side effects were headache, upset stomach, delayed backache, or muscle ache. Erections lasting longer than 4 hours, though rare, require immediate medical help. Discuss your health status with your doctor to ensure Cialis is right for you and you are healthy enough for sexual activity. Ask your doctor if a free sample of prescription Cialis is right for you. 36-hour Cialis. When the moment is right, will you be ready? One swing.
There's a new home run champion of all time.
Changed everything.
And it's Henry Aaron.
Remembering 7:15, all day April 8th, starting at 11:30 on ESPN Classic. John Wooden, Rick Pitino, two legendary coaches, back to back. Sports Century John Wooden premieres at 8 p.m. tonight, followed by the premiere of Sports Century Rick Pitino at 8:30, only on ESPN Classic.
87-78, Tigers. John Redden for Derek Taylor. Robinson all over him in the backcourt. Number two on Herb.
Only two ticks of the clock, though. 56 seconds now, and of course, I like what Purdue's doing. You don't get the steal, you foul, you put them at the line. You're just hoping, you're hoping they miss the front end of that one and one. It's the only chance you have.
Derek Taylor, good night at the line. Overall, he shoots 88%. As we told you earlier, this LSU team is a great free throw shooting team late. Maybe now it's too late as Taylor missed. Boilermakers need a basket in a hurry to get back to within seven. Doug Lee stuffed from behind by Williams. Todd Mitchell high off the glass. Or check it, it was Everett or Troy Lewis. And now Mitchell has the follow and draws the foul. How about that?
It's the one thing LSU did not want to have happen, a three-point trip. And that's exactly what Purdue has a shot at. That's the fifth foul against John Williams. He threw up a hope shot there, but who's there to get it? Mitchell, and he brings it home. Watch there, chance at a three-point trip. Purdue will not die, they keep hanging in. Big John Williams has just fouled out, 16 points, 8 boards. He played a little sick under the weather at the 24-hour virus, but as you mentioned, Bob, had to go double overtime and had to be very tough on this young man. He did not shoot well for him tonight.
And if they hang on to win this one in less than 48 hours, they'll take on a big, talented Memphis State team.
Purdue has a chance here to cut it to six with 43 seconds.
Nebojša Bukaminović back in there for LSU, a 6'4 sophomore. Yugoslavia. What a night for Todd Mitchell. He has a career-high 30. Wanting to add to it, he's 8 of 11 from the stripe.
He's now 9 of 12. He has 31 points.
87-81. 40 seconds remaining. Everett Stevens, the steal. Troy Lewis is drawing the foul.
This game is not over. With 38 seconds, they can now cut it to 4.
And that's 5 on Derek Taylor.
Taylor's going to go out, and they can cut it to 4, and there's 38 seconds. And everybody thought it was over. Don't leave. Look at it again. Long pass. Gamble. You can see the clock ticking. Right here. He still was moving the defensive player. It was a good call. And he reached in with the hands. Purdue not as good a free throw shooting team as LSU. Just 71% on the year. And that's just fair, not bad, but LSU 75%. Looked like it was totally over. LSU waltzed away. John Williams missed a stuff when he could have laid it in. Maybe a little hot dog at that point, Bob. We've got you put away. We'll put the icing on the cake. Purdue licked off the icing and it said, we will not give up. And they keep hanging tough.
Don't forget, another play similar. Derek Taylor, a 1-1 at the stripe about 30 seconds ago. Missing the front end. Purdue bringing it right down and scoring. If LSU somehow loses this game, about the only thing they could do would be to pull their own hair out, because it would be their fault for those two plays. Possible 8 points in a swing there. 4 they didn't get, and 4 Purdue did.
Give Purdue credit, though. They got that 3-point play by Mitchell, which was so key, and then they came right back with the steal. Good zone, full court pressure.
38 seconds left in the second overtime. After regulation, it was 69 each. After the first OT, it was 73 apiece. LSU exploded in this period, led by 10 a couple of times. Now it's 6. Troy Lewis was the man fouled.
He's shooting 81%. He's an excellent free throw shooter. He needs them both.
Looked like somebody was trying to send Everett Stevens to the line. Troy Lewis has 16 on the night. He averages 18.
Down to 5.
And a couple of Tiger fans are squirming here. This one looked like it was history moments ago.
4. Full court pressure.
On Redden. Gets it in for Bukaminovic. And a foul on Everett Stevens. Great. In the backcourt against Bernard Woodside, who is only a 52% free throw shooter.
Great percentage move by this coach right here, Gene Cady. Only 2 ticks of the clock went off, and they're going to put Woodside at the line, who is not a good free throw shooter. This game is now far from over. He misses here. They've got to come down and score quickly.
There's the free throw shooting percentage we mentioned. There's the miss, but he got his own rebound. He missed it so badly, it kicked way out.
Tough break for Purdue. They had everything they want to have happen.
There's a steal. Herb Robinson. Here comes Everett Stevens. This could be a 2-point game. Doug Lee has the rebound. And the basket.
18 seconds. The lead is 2. Can you believe it?
It's the NCAAs. Yes, I can.
Can you believe this? The Purdue Boilermakers. It looked like Gene Cady had almost given up himself, but he kept coaching. He kept fighting it. He kept calling timeouts. Watch it again. LSU got the ball back. All they had to do was hold it. And look at this wild pass here. It was kicked. That was the key. Stevens got a piece of it. The quick hands. You can see the clock ticking.
Watch Doug Lee right at your screen, posting up for rebounding position.
Good rebound. Watch him come back with it. Got it to the glass and got it to go. 18 ticks and you see it. LSU leads by 2. Unbelievable.
It was a 10-point LSU lead a couple of times in this overtime. They scored the first 8 points in the second OT period.
You think John Williams would like to have back the stuff that he missed?
Oh, yeah.
And he's fouled out.
So as Derek Taylor, who missed the front end of a 1-1 in a critical situation. We've got to play it pure now, down to the end without any stoppages. 18 seconds remaining. LSU with possession.
Purdue has to gamble on the steal again. And if they don't get it, they got to gamble of putting LSU at the line. The one player they don't want to foul is Don Redden. And he's the player LSU would love to get it in his hands.
And notice the guy with the lowest shooting percentage from the stripe, Woodside, is the man throwing
it in. And Lee is guarding Redden.
They get it into Anthony Wilson. Redden is loose down the court, but nobody saw him. Oh, Don Redden was loose for a touchdown pass. They couldn't get it to him. And a foul is at Herb Robinson. It'll be his third.
Well, they're going to put a man at the line who's shooting almost 88% on the year. But it was a good foul because, again, only two ticks. They trapped him right here. Watch it again. Got a piece of him. Well, he got a lot of him. No question about the call.
Anthony Wilson.
He hasn't been at the line, and he's never been under this much pressure. He's been 9 of 14, though, from the field, and this is his first free throw.
He only had five misses all year long, and three of them came in the season finale against Kentucky. So very consistent throughout the year, along with Don Redden, the best free throw shooter on the LSU team.
And he missed a couple of 1-1s against Kentucky in the semifinal round when it could have really made the difference.
Swish.
Oh, that was big for LSU.
Well, they just had to get the lid off the basket. It's been so long since they've been able to drop it through. Anthony, a great second half, 15 points since the intermission.
Remember, Purdue does not have any timeouts left.
The lead is now 89-85. They get it down the floor quickly. Troy Lewis behind the back dribble. What a move. He has 20. Clock running, 5 seconds left, and a foul. The lack of a timeout made a heck of a difference there.
Really hurt him with no timeouts. Good call, Bob, because you can see the ticks on the clock, and Gene Cady is roaring mad.
I think they've called a two-shot intentional foul.
I think they did, too.
Better not get a T here, Coach.
No, he can't afford that at all. If he has any chance at all. The officials, the Purdue team is talking to the officials about the call. I question it too, Bob. I have to admit it because it looked like just a trapping defense. But the official here is saying no. I'm calling a two-shot foul, and that's what it's going to be. What's happened here?
I don't know. Nobody from Purdue is down there rebounding. Maybe we've had a technical. We do have one on whether was it a player or the coach. We'll find out if they shoot one or two.
They're saying it's on the coach. I missed it completely.
Well, that's a suicide move at this point. You've got a minimal chance.
I think what happened was they called a two-shot foul, and Gene Cady evidently said something to official as he came by, so they slapped him with a technical foul as well. It's on the bench, so he'll shoot two more now. He'll shoot two more.
Well, that really takes any chance of victory away from Purdue. Two T's on Cady tonight.
One of the great comebacks, though, that I think I've seen in a long time, because Purdue was down 10, and they really hung in, and all of a sudden had this crowd very quiet. They'd cut it to two. They were fighting this LSU team for their life.
Twenty-three points for Anthony Wilson. He's made a living in the second half. The season is 4 seconds from being over for the Boilermakers of Purdue, who will finish 22-10. Keep them in the back of your mind for next year, though. Good young team. Everybody back but one guard as a senior. There's a foul on Troy Lewis. Somehow only 1 second off the clock there. What do you think about LSU and Memphis State on Saturday, Joe Dean?
I was tremendously impressed by Memphis State. They got the big guy, William Bedford, on the inside. He's a 7-footer, can really play. And Memphis State has great team speed. LSU, as we talked about here tonight, they do not have a true center. They play Jose Vargas some. He's big and strong, but he's still learning to play. And they've got to use 6'6", Ricky Blanton. So I like Memphis State. The only thing that may help LSU is this roaring crowd.
The only thing I wonder about the Tigers is if they look better than normal tonight against a Ball State team that looked pretty disinterested on defense.
That would be, as we talked about watching it, Ball State played very passively defensively, and Memphis State offense, if they could do anything they wanted to against them.
Anthony Wilson has 25. Everett Stevens lets it come in. There's the shot by Troy Lewis, and we'll see you later next year at Boilermakers. The final, 94-87 LSU in double overtime. For Joe Dean, this is Bob Carpenter. So long from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Saturday, it'll be the Tigers and the Tigers, LSU against Memphis State. Remembering.